This is what you must write to the angel of the church in Philadelphia. I am the one who is holy and true, and I have the keys that belonged to David. When I open a door, no one can close it, and when I close a door, no one can open it. Listen to what I say. I know everything you have done, and I have placed before you an open door that no one can close. You were not very strong, but you obeyed my message and did not deny. You are my followers. Those words come from Revelation chapter 3, verses 7 and 8. How strong do you need to be in order to be successful as a follower of Jesus? Well, these verses clearly answer that question. You do not need to be very strong, but you do need to be very obedient and very unashamed to declare that Jesus is your Lord. In your walk of faith, God opens the door for the way that you should go, and He closes the doors to opportunities that are not part of His plan for your life. Sometimes, though, we stand at a closed door for years, hoping that God will change His mind and let us through. Instead of seeking the way that He has prepared for us to walk, we may stop and wait at that closed door for a long time. Are you still standing at a door that God shut many years ago? Or maybe He shut the door just yesterday. Unless God has told you to wait at that door, you must move on and look for the door He has opened for your life. I think most Christians spend at least some of their lives waiting for closed doors to open. Lord Jesus, help me to know if the closed door that stands before me now was shut by You or is simply blocked by Satan. If the devil is blocking it, then move him out of the way. And if You have shut it, then move me on to the door You have opened for my life. And may You be praised forever. Amen.